One Punch Man fought Goku, would Saitama end the fight in one punch, or would Goku's strongest form take Saitama down? We're gonna find out who wins this fight, as well as what would happen if Saitama fought Gojo, Naruto, all the way down to if Saitama fought All Might. And while All Might in his prime is the strongest hero in My Hero Academia, he gets destroyed by Saitama. See, All Might's strongest punch can destroy a city, but a single punch from Saitama can destroy an entire star. Meaning that right off the bat, All Might can't afford to get hit. Saitama will probably take it easy and let All Might land a few punches, but they won't do any damage. And when Saitama goes to punch, there's only one way All Might will be able to survive, by perfectly landing his strongest punch on Saitama's incoming fist. But the chances of him pulling this off are less than 1% because Saitama is so fast. Even if All Might does pull this off, he'd stop the deadliest damage from the punch, but the force would shatter his arm. So basically, All Might has two opportunities to block Saitama's punches. And if All Might takes a direct punch after that, he dies immediately, making Saitama the winner. Later on, we'll pit One Punch Man against Luffy, Naruto, and then Goku. But first, what would happen if Saitama fought the strongest character in Demon Slayer, Muzan the Demon King? Now listen, Muzan is powerful, but we know he's not as strong as Saitama because he can't kill the strongest Demon Slayers in just one hit. And while we know from the manga that Muzan is faster than the speed of sound, we also know that Saitama is faster than the speed of light, making him at least 186,000 times faster than Muzan. So for Muzan, it's not even about winning the fight, it's about surviving it. And for this, he only has one ability that can help him survive, splitting into millions of tiny pieces and running away for dear life, a strategy he used successfully against Yorichi, the strongest Demon Slayer. If this happens, the fight might end in a draw, but Saitama also has a secret move he can use here, the serious sneeze. Yeah, I'm not joking. His sneeze once destroyed half of Jupiter, so simply sneezing would definitely turn every piece of Muzan into dust. Meaning Saitama is once again the clear winner. Now his next opponent is Luffy. And while you might think it's an easy win for Saitama, Luffy's latest power-up in the manga might have just given him a secret weapon. See, Luffy's current power level is called Gear 5, and some fans are saying this has unlocked the most powerful ability in all of anime, unlimited growth. Because if you look closely at Luffy's latest battles, it seems like he can grow in strength until he defeats any opponent. So fans are saying that if he went against Saitama, Luffy would start out weaker, but would eventually grow in power until he's strong enough to win. Unfortunately, everyone is wrong about this. Because while Luffy did get a huge power boost, he didn't unlock unlimited growth. So are his actual powers strong enough to beat One Punch Man? Well, that's where it gets interesting. See, in a fight, Saitama will have the upper hand in strength, but Luffy's durability might give him a chance to at least survive. With his latest power-up, he can take hits like a sponge. I mean, Luffy is literally made of rubber, which is perfect against punch attacks. But this is where things take a dark turn, because Saitama's punches are so strong that even if they don't make Luffy explode, the whiplash will end him. So yeah, game over for One Piece's main character. But what happens if Saitama fights Naruto, one of the strongest anime characters of all time? Who would end up winning? Well, let's compare Naruto's and Saitama's strength and speed. First, by the time we reach the end of the series, Naruto is so strong that he can destroy an entire continent. Now, that's not enough to beat Saitama's planet-killing punch, but it puts Naruto closer to winning than anyone else on this list so far. Second, Naruto is really fast. He's able to avoid the fastest attacks in his show, meaning that Naruto is at least faster than the speed of light, which is the closest we've gotten in this video to someone matching Saitama's speed. But Naruto's real strength comes in numbers. With his unlimited pool of chakra, he can summon thousands of clones to attack One Punch Man. Since Saitama can't sense chakra, he wouldn't be able to tell which Naruto is the real one, meaning the real Naruto can unleash some of his strongest attacks, like the super-tailed beast Rasen Shuriken. While this attack is super strong, it's unlikely it'll do much damage to Saitama. In fact, attacking Saitama with something this strong is a huge mistake, because after getting hit by something like this, Saitama will most likely stop messing around and unleash a serious punch, destroying the army of clones and seriously injuring the real Naruto. A second punch would end Naruto before he could do anything else. Dang, can we find anyone capable of taking a punch from Saitama? That's where Giorno Giovanna, the 15-year-old mafia boss, comes in. Giorno's definitely not a match for Saitama physically, but fortunately, apparently, he has a special ability that makes him invincible, called Return to Zero. If Saitama tries to hit Giorno, he'll be sent back in time to right before he tried attacking. So Giorno literally has an undo button for anything that can hurt him. Because of this, Saitama won't be able to do anything. He'll keep punching and punching, only to end up right back where he started. Unfortunately for Giorno, he can't really win the fight either. None of his powers are strong enough to harm Saitama. So for hours, these two would fight in one spot, trading blows. Saitama's punches all get undone, and Giorno's punches don't do any damage. This would get on Saitama's nerves, causing his strength to grow at a crazy rate. But it still wouldn't get him anywhere. At this point, a crowd would be forming. Why is this bald dude fighting a teenager? But these two don't even notice the crowd. They're only focused on the fight. They've wasted so much time already that they both feel like they have to win. Unfortunately, neither will be able to pull it off, and the fight either ends in them giving up or dying of old age. So that leaves Saitama with a record of 4 wins and 1 draw. I think it's time to crank up the difficulty a notch. And that's where fan favorite Satoru Gojo comes in. We gotta start off by talking about the only ability that has a chance to defeat Saitama, Gojo's Limitless. It's like a small barrier around Gojo's body created from cursed energy. The closer an enemy gets to Gojo, the stronger the repulsion will be, meaning that no one can touch him. The craziest part about this technique is that it uses less energy than Gojo's body naturally creates, meaning he can keep this ability up forever. So the big question is, can One Punch Man break through Gojo's Limitless? If he can, Gojo loses the fight. If Saitama can't break through, Gojo can now start phase 2 of his strategy to defeat Saitama by using an ability called Domain Expansion. This ability will end the fight immediately. When Gojo uses this, his opponent instantly sees the entire universe, essentially turning them brain dead. This means that if Saitama can't punch through Gojo's Limitless or stop him from activating his domain, it could be game over. However, even though it's very hard, domains can be destroyed. And considering the fact that Saitama can literally punch through stars, it's safe to say that he would have the power to free himself from the domain. That is, if he doesn't immediately feel the effects. But I find it unlikely that this fight could even get to this point. In my opinion, Saitama would be able to break through Gojo's Limitless with ease. But like I said, there's still the chance that this barrier is impossible to get through. I have way more faith in Saitama's limitless strength than Gojo's limitless protection. If these two fought, I think it would be an easy win for One Punch Man. While Saitama has beaten everyone in this video so far, Goku will be the first hero to hand One Punch Man a loss. Listen, if we look at a fight where Saitama went all out, his punches have the power to destroy an entire planet. And when Saitama fights in outer space, the shockwaves alone can destroy thousands of stars, while a single sneeze can destroy half of Jupiter. Now this sounds impressive, but compared to what Goku's packing, it's not much. If you look at Goku's very first fight in Dragon Ball Super, he already had the power to destroy the entire universe. What's even scarier is that this fight happened 8 years ago, and since then, Goku has grown stronger than a couple gods in his universe. But strength isn't the only way to win a fight. Speed is important too. When it comes to speed, Saitama is the fastest creature in his universe, able to run faster than Flashy Flash, a hero who can run at the speed of light. Even crazier, Saitama is so fast that his movements create beams of light, somehow causing planets to form. So at the very least, Saitama is way faster than the speed of light, so there's no way Goku can beat that, right? Unfortunately for Saitama, Goku has a secret trick up his sleeve, a technique called instant transmission that allows him to teleport anywhere instantly. Now some fans say it's not even teleportation, Goku is just so fast that it looks like he's teleporting, but Goku can go even faster. See, in chapter 72 of the super manga, Goku fights someone who's way faster than his teleportation, and by the end of the fight, he powers up so much that he's able to keep up with his opponent. Okay, so Goku is both stronger and faster than Saitama, meaning that Saitama can only win by turning to his secret advantage. See, the creator of One Punch Man revealed that Saitama's superpower isn't his strength. It's his ability to get exponentially stronger whenever he fights someone more powerful than him. For example, in his ultimate battle against Garo, Saitama starts out way weaker, but the fight lasts so long that he eventually surpasses Garo in strength. So, against Goku, Saitama only has a chance to win if the fight drags on. But if Goku decides to go all out right at the beginning, it's game over for Saitama, meaning that in a fight between them, Goku is the winner. Now that's crazy, but click this video if you want to see something even crazier. Click it!